Several weeks ago, we posted a video of the Charging Compatibility 100 test of the brand new 15-inch MacBook Air, and many of you guys requested a more detailed charging review for this laptop. So let's go ahead and test it today. According to Apple's official website, you can choose 35W dual USB-C or 70W charger for this laptop when you place the order. So we will test both of those two chargers to see what's the difference. What we got is a Midnight One. It comes with a MagSafe 3 cable of the same color. The USB-C connector on the other side does not adopt a full pin design. The charger that powers ZKM003C shows is equipped with an eMarker chip and can support 240W PD3.1, and the length is about 2 meters. It integrates a 66.5Wh battery pack, which supports up to 15 hours of wireless web and 18 hours of video playback. The thickness is about 11.5mm, and the weight is only 1.5kg. It reminds me of the LG Gram series. If we use the default 35W charger inside the box to charge it, the charging power will be limited to 35W. We also charge it with a brand new 70W GaN charger, the power will be limited to 70W. So, what about a higher charger? We tried Apple 96W and 140W, the power is only about 71W, which should be the max spendable power of this laptop. In addition, the charging power of the USB-C is the same as that of MagSafe 3 port, just to choose the one you'd like. As for the charging compatibility, you can click the upper right corner to check the video we posted before. We tested all kinds of charging devices, such as Apple original chargers, third-party chargers, power banks, and portable power stations. All of them can charge this 15-inch MacBook Air successfully. Next, let's use the 35W charger in the box to charge it fully, which is also the choice of most people. Here is the charging curve made by the PC software of KM003C. The voltage is pretty stable at 20V, and the charging power from 0 to 1 hour and 40 minutes is almost a straight line at 35W. Afterward, there are small fluctuations. At 1 hour and 57 minutes, the power slowly drops to almost 0. It takes 2 hours and 52 minutes to be fully charged. We also use the 70W GaN charger to charge it fully. The charging curve can be divided into 4 parts. The voltage is always around 20.6V, and the peak power is about 67W at 35 minutes. Then it gradually drops to 50W and 33W in turn. The final part begins at 1 hour and 14 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost 0. It takes 2 hours and 90 minutes to be fully charged. We put those two charging curves in one chart, which can be more intuitive to see which is faster. When charging the MacBook Air from 0 to 50%, the 70W charger is about twice as fast as the 35W charger. But after that, it'll be slowed down. The 70W charger is only 42 minutes faster than the 35W charger when it is charged to 80%. In the end, the 35W charger takes 33 minutes longer to fully charge the MacBook Air than the 70W charger. You can make a decision based on your needs and budget. When testing the full charging curve, we put the charger into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank and got its surface temperature. Firstly, let's see the 35W charger. After 30 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 29.9 degrees Celsius and 29.6 degrees Celsius on the back. After 60 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 31.2 degrees Celsius and 30.9 degrees Celsius on the back. So the overall temperature is pretty stable at around 30 degrees Celsius. And the keyboard will be hotter than the back case. Then let's move on to the 70W charger. After 30 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 34.7 degrees Celsius and 33.4 degrees Celsius on the back. After 60 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 30.4 degrees Celsius and 30.2 degrees Celsius on the back. This time, the overall temperature is a little higher than 35W at around 32 degrees Celsius. Well, that's all the tests we made for this 15-inch MacBook Air. The larger size not only brings a larger display, but also a larger battery and better heat dissipation performance. So even if it's fast charged for an hour, the temperature will not exceed your body temperature. It also has good compatibility with different charging devices. But for the fastest charging speed, we recommend choosing Apple's 70W charger or other third-party PD chargers beyond 70W. Okay, that's all for today's video. Don't forget to drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!